Hello everybody, today we're going to see some greetings and how to introduce yourself, the basics. When it's informal, we use salut. Salut. Salut means hello, ni hao. When you know the person, when it's your family, when this is your friend, you say salut. Salut. Salut, it's used to when you meet the person and when you say salut means hello and hi, but also goodbye. Bonjour means literally good day, like they say in Australia. Bonjour, we say bonjour when in a formal case, when it's morning and afternoon. After 7 p.m., we say bonsoir. Bonsoir means good evening. After when you meet the person in formal case, we say au revoir, means zaijian, goodbye. If you want, if you meet the person in the night, you can say bonne nuit, have a good night, have a good night. Bonne soirée means have a good evening. If you meet the person in the morning, before noon, you can say bonne journée, means have a good day. S'il vous plaît means please, please. Pardon means excuse me, sorry. Doebuti. If you want to say thank you, xie xie, you say merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. In France, contrary to China, when we know the person, if it's a friend, if it's the family, generally men between them shake their hands. But with women, between them and between men and women, when it's of course in formal case, in friendly frame, in family, they kiss. We kiss from 1 to 5 times. But when it's formal, when you don't know the person, if a job, we shake the hands and not more. As well with men than with women. Whereas in China, you don't kiss, only it can be strange for you if a day you go to France. Now we are going to see some greetings. Comment tu t'appelles? Comment tu t'appelles means Ni Jiao Shen Ma means what's your name? The answer is Je m'appelle Marie. Wo Jiao Marie. My name is Marie. No. Another question, alors. Je m'appelle Marie. My name is Marie. Quel âge tu as? How old are you? Ni disuelle, ni dwordale. If you want to say how old you are, the answer is J'ai 12 ans. I am 12 years old. Wo yo she her. Non. Quelle est ta nationalité? What's your nationality? Ni she nagojen ma. If you want to answer. Je suis française. I am French. Wo she fa guo zhen. Quelle est la date de ton anniversaire? When is your birthday? anniversaire, birthday, shengju. Shengju. C'est le 2 janvier. It's on January 2. In English, we use you. You. But in French, that depends on if we know the person or if we don't know the person. You means vous or tu. Vous, tu. Quel est votre nom de famille? Quel est ton nom de famille? What is your last name family? But in English, we say you. But we don't know if we talk to one people or to several people. Also, we don't know if we know the person or if we don't know if it's a friend or if it's a professional case. That's why in French, if we know the person, we say tu. Tu. If we don't know the person, if we want to be polite, if we meet the person for the first time, we say vous. Quelle est, in a formal case, we say quel est votre nom de famille? In informal cases, we say quel est ton nom de famille? Mi Jiao Shen Man means what is your last name? Ni Xing Shen Man means mon nom de famille est Auvergne. My last name est is Auvergne. Watching Auvergne. You see, the answer is the same. But the difference is that what we say, the first case, quel est votre... When we say, quel est votre nom de famille, it's a case you don't know the family, the person. Or you meet this person for the first time. Now, if it's with a friend, we say, quel est ton nom de famille. A second question. Quel est votre prénom? Quel est ton prénom? These two questions have the same meaning, the same translation in English. What's your first name? But when we say your, we don't know if you know the person or if you don't know the person. Quel est votre nom de famille? Ni Jiao Shen Ma means the same when you say quel est ton nom de famille. Je m'appelle Matteo. My first name is Matteo. Wo Jiao Matteo. Now, if you want to ask ni Duodale, ni Zuisele, ni Zisuele, how old are you? Always, this is the same problem in English. You, we don't know if you know the person, if you don't know the person. Even we don't know if we talk to several people, only one person. Vous avez quel âge? Tu as quel âge? The two means ni duodale. How old are you? When we say vous avez quel âge? We don't know the person. Or we meet the person for the first time. Tu as quel âge? Vous and tu means you. But tu, it's when we know the person. Or it's meant between children. Because the children between them say tu. But a child with an adult, or between two adults, they say vous. J'ai 20 ans. I am 20 years old. What your
Hershey.
Now, if you want to ask the nationality. Quelle est votre nationalité? Mean, what's your nationality? Quelle est ta nationalité? What's your nationality? Ni shenagogen ma. In English, it's always the same problem. We don't know if you know the person, if you don't know the person. But in French, we have, when we say, quelle est votre nationalité? Means we don't know the person. Or we meet the person for the first time, but we want to be polite. When we say, quelle est ta nationalité? It's between children or we know the person. Je suis chinois. Je suis chinoise. I am Chinese. 我是中国人. Je suis français. Je suis française. I am French. 我是法国人. And also, what is important is that in French, we have also two cases. Contrary to English and Chinese, we make a difference between men and women. Chinois means, je suis chinois, means it's a man or a boy. We have a female from chinoise. Chinoise means it's a woman. And you see the pronunciation is totally different. When it's a man, je suis chinois, we don't pronounce the final S. When it's for women, chinoise, we pronounce the final S when we don't pronounce the final I. The same. Je suis français, je suis française. I am French. 我是法国人. Français, it's a man. Française, it's a woman. Here also you see, français for a man, we don't pronounce the final S. Française, the pronunciation is different. C'est 16. Français, française. We pronounce the final S, but we don't pronounce the final I. Vous êtes célibataire ou marié? Tu es célibataire ou marié? Well, of course, when we talk, some letters are not pronounced. Are not pronounced. But when it's written, it's different, totally different. But we're going to see this later. Because when we talk to one person, when we speak, it's the same pronunciation. Vous êtes célibataire ou marié? You are married or single. Célibataire, single. Married, marié. Tu es célibataire ou marié? You are single or married. You can see that is the same. Vous, we don't know the person. Or we meet this person for the first time. Tu es célibataire ou marié? Also, it's between the children or the person, the two persons know them. Je suis célibataire. I am single. What is good to know is that to ask. In France, we never ask a woman how old she is. It's not good. It's good to know this because if you ask a woman how old she is, she's not going to like it. It's the same when we don't ask, we never ask the weight to a woman. Never. These two questions are not good. Quelle est votre profession? Quelle est ta profession? What do you do? What is your job? Ni de gonzo, ma? In this case also, quelle est votre profession? We don't know the person. We meet the person for the first time. Quelle est ta profession? We know the person. Or, a children talk to a person, a young children.
Je suis professeur.
Mi wo shi lao shi. I am a teacher. Generally, we have also name for men and for women, but in French we use more the male noun, even if the teacher is a woman. Now we're going to see the alphabet. The alphabet is the same like in English, but the pronunciation is different. Most of letters are different. A, the letter A. A. You open the mouth. A, very, very big. A. B. B. C. D. Repeat the first letter. A. B, C, D, E. No. The letter I. E. E. Here you have the letter written in capital letter and in small letter. E. When you say A, A in English, we open very widely the mouth. When you say E, we open a little. F. F. G. G. H. Contrary to English, with the letter H, there is no accent. All the words started by the letter H, there is no accent. A. B. C, D, E, F, G, H, I. You see, the letters are the same like in English, but the pronunciation is totally different. After G, J, K. L, M, N. These three letters I like in English. L, M, N. O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, you can see that this letter is like two V. In English, we say W. It's like two U. But here, it's with two V. W. X, Y, Z. It's important to know the alphabet because if a day you want to book a hotel, or you want to book also a table to go to, when you want to go to a restaurant, they can ask you your name, your last name, and to spell it. We are going to repeat another time the word alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, without accent, without stress, without tone on this letter, contrary to English. I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T,
U-V-W-X-Y-Z.
It's finished for this day. We're going to see the numbers another time. Goodbye.